Hey guys, what's up? In this video, I'm going to tell you about resistances and supports. I'm going to teach you how to find them, why they're useful, and how they can help you become a better trader. We're going to start by identifying the obvious, obvious supports and resistances. So we're going to go up to our tools. All of our tools are on the left side of the screen. For now, we are only going to go up to trend lines. I prefer to use horizontal rays. You'll see me use them a lot. However, horizontal line is really the same thing. Horizontal line is just going to project it all the way, a line from the left to the right side out to infinity in both directions. Whereas the ray is going to only begin the line or the horizontal where you select it, and it will project it out to the right into the future. I like these simply because I think anything we can do to cut down on visual unneeded stimulus is going to help us be more successful. A lot of these you really won't find yourself using often. In this list, the ones that I use most often would be trend lines, horizontal rays, very occasionally vertical lines, and semi-commonly parallel channels. So how do we find supports and resistances, major ones, important values that are going to give us an anchor to then start doing technical analysis? Essentially, what we're going to be searching for is where we see price move in one direction and then reverse. The areas that stand out to me are right here. This is December 1st, 2017. We see a large rally that is sold off and reverses. This suggests that there is likely resistance here. So I'm going to place that trend line. What you'll notice is this actually isn't perfectly there. We are humans and we're not perfect at placing things. So an important tool that I find for doing this, scroll all the way down, you'll see this little magnet guy. Give him a click. And what this does is instead of allowing you to freely place these, it will attempt to snap these lines either to wicks or to the bodies of the candles. Not a lot of people do this, I've noticed. I like it because it's giving you the exact value. Price is currently right there. It has traded above it, sold back below it. That's a good sign that this is a valid resistance. Resistances can only ever be above price, and supports can only ever be below price. What we can also do is take the highest point in price at any given time, which is 420 on Litecoin. And we can assume that this is likely to be some resistance as well. The highest point in price on any chart is likely to act as resistance. So we've identified two. We're going to look at potential supports. So the lowest point in price is likely to be a support as well. However, that is so far away from price that this is unlikely to ever really interact meaningfully. So we're going to look for that same thing that we found up here. We're going to look for ones that are a little closer to price so they can be more relevant. What stands out to me is this peak where we saw price increase and then reverse. So I'm going to place that again right here. Because price is above this newly generated ray, we can assume this is support. It is below price, so it may support it if we see a sell-off that reaches that level. The monthly is really rarely going to give you significant points because it's showing us so much time. It's not always going to be super important by itself, standalone, but it's important just to zoom out and get a map of where this asset is traded. So now that we have a support below us, a resistance where we are, and a resistance above, we have a good guideline. When you change time frames, you'll notice that you no longer can see everything. Use your mouse scroll wheel to manipulate the time scale or the x-axis here. You can also do it by moving your mouse down to where the date is, clicking and holding, and you can adjust it this way as well. All right, we're on the weekly. We're a little more zoomed in. We're starting to get a picture. What you'll notice right away, maybe not, is that our monthly areas that we identified previously don't perfectly line up with the weekly. That at first might not make sense, but it makes sense if you think of weeks don't always end at the same time as months. Weekly supports and resistances should be identified as well. Looking at what's happened here recently, we see that price has moved above that monthly resistance, back tested it, and now moved up to test the monthly resistance that we identified earlier. In doing so, right here, we saw price reverse, and we can logically assume that in that act, orders, buy orders, and sell orders were executed, thus creating a price level that's important, a new one. That's at 170 here. The longer the time frame, the more important. This support we identified actually is already a support. Well, this is cool. I didn't think that we'd have this episode. Look at me learning while I'm doing a lesson. So what we had here actually was a resistance, and we saw that as price approached it, pulled back, tested that support. That wasn't necessarily created by this price action, but it was confirmed by this weekly price action. I personally like to turn my raise, if they are support, green, red if they are resistance, and I think it's important to distinguish between the two. But now you can see that we have somewhat of a map going on. We've broken down what could be viewed as any value between $22 and $420. We've broken that down to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 price points. 7 price points is a lot easier to deal with than any integer or any number in between. We're going to continue again. So we're going to go up to the top left, where we selected the weekly, and we're gonna go to the daily. We're gonna zoom it back out again, and we're gonna get an idea. How has price interacted with these levels? Pretty well, actually. We saw consolidation here on the daily, and that was a weekly resistance that it broke. We saw that resistance prove that it was resistance by rejecting this rally. When the market was ready, when bulls had enough power, they broke through it, back-tested that support, pushed the price up farther. Sellers pushed the price back down to support. It held, and buyers entered the market again, breaking the previous high. And we can see that at each of these levels, not only is it trading there multiple times, it has a tendency to reach one of these levels, reject, meaning turn around, gather strength, only to push through it. What we commonly see as price moves up is rejected by it as resistance. The market pushes again through that resistance when it tests it, and then back tests it as support. So right here, this was resistance. Once the market broke through it, sold off back to it, it flipped that resistance to support. We see this very commonly. It is not guaranteed, but this is more often than not. Once that price is broken, we see that the market tends to, it's called back test, come back to that same price again and attempt to break it in the other direction. And if it holds, then we flip from resistance to support. And we see that here actually pretty clearly, which is cool. So now that we're zoomed into the daily, we're going to do the exact same practice that we just did on the monthly and the weekly. What I first see here is these multiple candle closes on the daily. The market was unable to push above and sold off. However, it looks as if $227 seems to be holding as support. These candle closes were unable to break 237, but the selling pressure was unable to break and close above 227. So to me, that's a valid support, but we have another resistance to add. Because of these candles closing and opening and unable to break through, we have a daily resistance at 237. And now what we've really established here is a trading range. What we just talked about, here's a good example, is price moved up to resistance, sold off, managed to break it, and now it's pulled back and tested it as support. What I would expect now is to see either a break to the upside of 237 or a break to the downside if 227 doesn't hold, and possibly retest support down here. A break to the upside, the next logical move would be to look to our next resistance, 324. This is a pretty basic look on a chart, but by starting on a long time frame without using any indicators, without using anything fancy, we've gone through and identified multiple price points of significance on different time frames. And in reality, we could look to trade using just these, nothing else, no news, no divergence, no moving averages. I think this is the fundamental aspect of technical analysis, is we are looking to beat the odds of just flipping a coin or guessing. So there we go. I think that's a pretty good breakdown of how to approach a chart. The trick is start zoomed out, identify important price values, start zooming in, continue to zoom in, and you'll find that these hold true. I didn't take nearly as long as I thought.